And now our continuing series on the greatest songs of all time. From 1970, Paul McCartney, Maybe I'm Amazed. Now, McCartney wrote the song in 1969, just before the Beatles' breakup. He dedicated it to his wife, Linda, who helped him get through those tough times. Now, later, McCartney and his band Wings released a single of a live version of the song from the 1976 tour of America. Now, that song became a top 10 hit in the U.S. and reached number 26 in the U.K. But today, we're talking about the album version. And although most of his debut solo album was recorded at his farm in Scotland, McCartney recorded Maybe I'm Amazed entirely in EMI's number 2 studio in London. That's where he was mixing the rest of the tracks. And like Stevie Wonder, he played all the instruments, guitars, piano, organ, and drums, though he was joined on harmony by Linda. Now, Paul declined to release the song as a single, it nonetheless received a great deal of radio airplay, considered one of McCartney's finest love songs. And in a late 2009 interview with a journalist in London promoting his Good Evening New York City album, McCartney said, "Maybe I'm Amazed. That's the song I'd like to be remembered for in the future." Released April 1970 on Apple Records, spent 13 weeks on the charts, and reached number 10. Certainly one of the greatest songs of all time. From 1970, Paul McCartney, Maybe I'm Amazed.
Maybe I'm amazed away.